Hello, boys and girls, welcome to the game Witness. One of my Dwarf Fortress stream viewers, I think it was Izix, suggested this game to me because it somehow fits my playing style, and yes, he was right, it caught my interest. And it's refreshingly different from other games I have seen recently. And this is a puzzle solving game and a free roam exploration game, so let's take a look at it. Okay. Oh, dark, dark cave. Too dark, I would say. Can't see anything in these corners. This is probably another door. So, and release. Okay. So this is like a garden. We sit here. Is this a watering hose or? Oh, I see my own shadow. Look at this. The pentagonal tower. Wow. But sort of purposeless, right? Because there's a catwalk over there. Hmm. I don't know which way should I taken, whether to go this way or the shorter way. But we seem to have activated something by solving this puzzle. Ah, it's probably that opens another thing, and I guess we need to deactivate all three of them. So let's look at where this wire goes. Oh, we've seen it. Okay, it goes somewhere where we can't access it. Yeah. Okay, what about the other guy? Many more puzzles, but these seem to be very simple ones right now. I will just draw a line where possible. Okay, so this is not activated yet. Probably need to activate this first. Look at these bricks here. They look like they could be removed. Hello, Yugoslavenka. Hello, guys. Welcome to the stream. Place, nice spot to take a rest. Okay, I have no idea what this will do, but let's take a look at it. Cannot start here. Cannot start here. Ah, I must start here. Good. I don't know which way to go to take. Aha, it lit up this wire, and if I make the other one too. It will probably light up the other one. But it deactivated this one. And only one can be activated at a given time. All right. Well, now I've activated this one, so something over there must have changed. Ah, that's this wire, I see. Okay, we have revealed the second part of this. This can be solved right away. Okay. So this was this. Now we can solve this. So far, it's quite easy. I'm trying to get the shortest way to the various targets. So now all three pieces of this puzzle are revealed. Yeah. Well, there is no shortest way here. Is this all I could have done here? It can't be all. There was one puzzle which was either one way or the other, and I only solved it one way. Here, this one. I'll have to activate this. I wonder whether this did not deactivate the gate again. No, it did not deactivate it. Okay. Well enough then. Can we climb these walls? Well, no. Probably just some decoration stones here. They probably can't be removed. Okay, so far so good. Pretty easy. I watched a review of this game by IGN, and they said, well, you can solve the puzzles, of course, but you don't only need to solve them, you need to understand them. Only when you understand these puzzles will you be able to solve and understand the harder ones or understand the greater context. So, well, I don't quite understand these puzzles yet, I think. Like, I'm not sure whether to go the shortest way or what happens if I solve the puzzle taking the longer way there. Actually, let's take a look at the puzzle we solved last time, where we switched from one solution to another. No, this wasn't it. I think this was it. And let's see where this where this cable goes. It goes out that window. Out that window. Yeah. Goes completely out of this. Out of this little castle. All right, let's move it. Let's get out here and see what's here. Optimus is asking, what kind of game is this? Well, this game is called Witness. It's a puzzle solving exploration game, and New Embark in Dwarf Fortress. I might wait until I have some good idea about a fortress. I tried to play New Fortress today, but it was more or less just one for fun. Look at this. Where we embarked on a terrifying biome, and I didn't really want to play it. I just wanted to see what a terrifying biome looks like and feels like. It's a strange device. Okay. They tell me to. It seems that the shift moves a little bit faster. Oh yeah, it does. Okay. Not too much faster, but a little bit faster. Oh, look, there's some sort of door. Oh. Looks like another puzzle there. Looks like a hobbit house here. But they usually have round doors, not like this. What is this? I have no idea what to do here. Like, yes, you could start at any of these round things and end up. Here's something like steps. Is anybody here? Ah, that's probably one of the puzzles which I don't understand yet at all. I shouldn't be trying to solve them. I think if I jump down, I will never get up and never get up here again. Okay, let's take a look at this. It's probably the way and order you are supposed to go. What's that blue thing there? I hear steps. I clearly hear steps. Or not like steps, but something rustling here. Now it's just blue sky here. Ooh, look. Wait, this is the other side of the Hobbit house, isn't it? Of course it is. Can we jump in? Well, I would only jump in if I knew I could get out. And look, this is where we were. This is where we started. And now I'm on this catwalk. This was the gate. Nice. I like the shadow. Hello, shadow. I wonder which tower it was where we have solved the puzzle where we switched to the other wire. Obviously, it wasn't this one. Could have been this. So how many towers are here? And this is the one. Let's count them. This was it. Yeah, we've solved this puzzle, and I wonder where this wire goes. This is the second tower. This wire goes someplace. Someplace over there. And all are pentagonal, aren't they? This is also a pentagonal tower. Right, it is. And the roof. Can we step on the roof? Yes, we can. And there are more pillows here. And what is this? A nice view of that mountain over there. It's like a crystal. And the same symbol is on the piece of paper and under the crystal as is on this pillow. Okay. So there was two towers, three tower, third tower, okay. We jump down? No, we can't jump down. Okay. Optimus S, yeah, it's nice game, beautiful graphics. Well, the graphics are certainly refreshing and bright. How did we even got here? Ah, yeah. How did we even get here? Five, six. Okay. Yes, all right. So let's take a look. But over there, maybe we will see where the wire goes. Ah, here comes the wire. Look at this, we have opened this gate. That's what we've opened with the puzzle. Ah, yes, yes, yes. Clouds aren't moving. I think this was the door which I saw from the other side. Can it be? I think it can be. Yeah, what to do here? What are these black dots? That didn't feel right. Neither did this. What if we are to connect all the black dots and end up here? Oh yes. Oh yes. There is some sort of electronics here. Looks like this arrow tells you what direction to go first. Like if we try this, maybe it will not be right. Exactly. Neither will, oh come on. Neither should this be right. But this, come on, this should be right. That sounds good. but I don't know what happened. Oh, didn't it open the... No, it didn't. I don't know what it did. It must have changed something. This one's still blinking. Okay, let's connect all the black dots here. Now, first think. I think I got it. Do you? Let's try it. Ha! How wrong I was. Maybe, well, I'm thinking that my line must not cross itself. Maybe the line can cross itself. Like that I could do something like this. Ah, no, it can't. Okay, now we know. Now we know. So we can't cross the line here. I know for sure that I was thinking right. So let's try it. Well, let's think. Bugzoid suggested press the blinking thing. Ah, okay, thanks. I will try to. I'll get back there once I have solved this puzzle. Oh, it's so easy. All right. Well, let's get back to that blinking thing and try to press it. Maybe something will happen. Where was it anyway? I totally forgot where it was. No, it must have been over there. Here it is. Come here, blinking thing.
Of all the communities available to us, there's not one I would want to devote myself to, except for the Society of True Searchers, which has very few living members at any time. Albert Einstein, 1924.
Okay, so we opened this door, I think. Yes, that's true. Ah, that was the door we saw, and I thought, okay, we can't open it, but we got there, yeah. So now we know that the black dots have to be connected all on the map. All the black dots on the map have to be connected. And there were some white dots as well, but the black dots are over here, and there are black dots in the grid. I still don't know what to do here. Okay, but there is more puzzles, right? Look at this greenhouse, or what is it? It's not exactly a greenhouse. Ah, maybe this is where we learn about the black dots. Okay. Can we cross the line here? Because I can't see a solution without crossing the line. can't cross the line. How is this possible without crossing the line? Ah, of course. Okay, next up. I like these puzzles. Yes, okay. Yeah. That was good. I just misclicked at the end. Where are the two starting points? It's strange. Can we cross the line at these points at least? No. Come on, click the right button. This is hard. I have no idea yet. So it can't be this, because there are only two ways out of this. Either you go like this, And that is not possible, or you go this. Ah, from here, this, this, this. Ah, we have it. Okay. Okay. What now? Something must have happened here, but I don't know what happened. We just solved a puzzle. I like to see something change when I solve a puzzle. Here I did not see anything change. Oh, let's learn about these things. So what does the white square mean and what does the black square mean? So the primitive solution would be like this. Okay. That doesn't want to. Okay, so black and white wants to have a line in between, probably. Okay. Black and white wants to have a line in between. What if I draw this? That was right. Why was this right? Why was this not right? This was also right. Okay. Two blacks can have a line in between. This solution. Well, okay, that can't be. Ah, actually, this is the only one because you can't go like this. I see, yeah. So this one's got only one solution. So okay. What? What did these want? Ah, it's like a. Ah, I see. I forgot. Yes, 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 indeed. I forgot. I forgot. And the rest is free. Okay, next up. Thank you. Ha! I'm trapped. Okay. This will be interesting. I need a line here, line here. Zounds. What happened here? Why does it not want? Something I don't understand about these things. Okay, two blacks must not be, but why could they be here? Why doesn't it? Why is this not wrong? I guess they want to be separated by another line. Of course, this will be wrong as well. This start in the top right corner, then down, was probably referencing the other puzzle I couldn't solve. But I don't understand yet what these dots want. The black dots were perfectly fine over here. White and black needs to have a line in between. Let's go even further back. Okay, there is no other solution to this, but we could have solved this like this. Ha! Now something tells me here. Uh-huh. As if the white ones wants to be enclosed, and the black ones must not be enclosed, somehow enclosed. But what does it mean to be enclosed? So the white ones want to be enclosed. No. Ha. This will not work, we know it. There is white and black somehow not separated. So even if they are not adjacent, they must not. There must be a line in between, even if they are. So the only option is pretty much here. Okay. And the black ones, I see. The black ones must group. I must not separate a black group. And I probably must not separate a white, but here I did separate a black group. Why did this work? Let me try something. This is all right. And if I separate a black. No, wait, okay. So. Here and, but I could have also done like this. That's weird. This black one doesn't complain about being separated from the others. Mm-hmm. The only option is to go upward here. Then here. I have still no idea what is or isn't allowed here around these black things. Black and white can't be bound within the same region. They need to be opposite side of the line. And the blacks need to be at one side of the line and whites. I have all whites on one side of the line and all blacks on the other side of the line. All whites. Here it is not the case. I have some whites on the left, plus this one is on the left. Why does it allow me one black to be on the left side, while others are on the right side of the line? Here I have whites on the right, blacks on the left. Whites on the left, blacks on the right. Whites on the right, blacks on the left. But this is still a mystery. Why does it allow this? Well, okay. But thank you, William. That's whites are always on the same side, however, you say. Even here, whites are all on the left. Yes, whites are all on the left. Here, whites are all on the right. And all blacks are on the left. Okay, so maybe whites have to be on one side. And with blacks, it does not matter. So it's not really exactly about separation, but about whites being all on one side of the line, it seems. So the main thing is that all whites need to be on the same side of the line. It's the only explanation I have, which is consistent across all of the puzzles there, which means now we probably could go back and to that bunker and try to solve that one. Because now I know what these mean. Now I know what all of this means. We need to pass through all of the black dots and have all whites on one side of our line. Okay. Now this is too complicated. Is it? Okay, let's try. We decide to have whites on the right. Whites on the right, whites on the right, whites on the okay, that's not possible, is it? Wait, it is possible. Whites on the No, this is already wrong. I have one right, one left. Okay, so if I have one right, one white right, this is all so okay, not like this. Maybe start here. If we go white's on the right. White's on the right, white's on the right. White has to be on the right. White has to be on the right. Okay, we will never separate these two, so that is not possible either. So white is, and okay, so white, no, we can't start here. Looks like only possible start is over here. So I can't start here. If I start here, I'll never separate black and white. So it's not possible to start here. It's not possible to start here either because there are two black dots and you will never go through both of them if you start here. So the only possible starting point is, wait, we have not excluded this one yet. Well, does it mean you have to separate them? Does it mean there has to go a line through them? Yes, it does. Because if the line does not go through here, and you have on the right, you could have a line like this. Suppose you pick up the black one. Like this, it should be possible, right? You've black on the right, white on the left. Let's ignore this point. We should try if it's possible to have white on the left, black on the right, without having a line through them. I guess there is not much room for this here. We'll have to try it there. Okay, so what if we start like this? Now we have decided white is on the left, black must be on the right. White is on the left, black is on the right. And this is not possible because no matter what we do, we are forced to go like this. Well, it is possible. We can end in the lower right corner. So white is on the left. White must be on the left. White must be on the left. White must be on the left, on the left, on the left, on the left. And blacks must be on the right. On the right, on the right, on the right, on the right, on the right. Oh yes, oh yes. What is this? A safe. A safe. With a difficult lock. Ooh. What is this? It's like a puzzle pattern, solution to a certain puzzle. Okay, not much we can do here, can is it? Like, and that tree over there, yeah, we saw it. Okay. Well, who knows where we will need this sort of information. William is commenting, what's most important is that they are in their own region. I think of the line as an edge of a container needs to be inside black. Well, so far the white on one side, black on other side of the line has worked fairly well. I have not found a contradiction to this rule yet. Okay, so what else can we take a look at? We've been here, right? We have walked up there, solved puzzles over there. There is nothing really here. No, sir, there is nothing. So let's we've been here. This was the Einstein message. Oh, this is just a view of what's coming. Bunker is solved. Nothing's hiding here, is there? These birch trees. Okay, the greenhouse is solved. Small tree growing here, birch tree. All right, let's take a look at this sort of. What is this? Ooh. It's like a sort of. Plowing or some sort of farming device. Okay. Ooh, look at this. Rust and iron and industry. Cables. Oh, this is mirrored. Okay. Oh, different sorts of pots. Very weird forms. Looks like each pot is divided into thirds. This one has the upper third, upper and lower, two upper, full. Oh, it's a binary code. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes, binary code. Okay, I got it. It's a binary representation of numbers. Or representation of binary numbers? Well, anyway, you get my meaning. Yeah. So, yeah, where do we activate this? Over there. Castle. Okay. Okay. Oh, is this now? I can't start there. All right. What is this? Oh, we need to activate this thing first. That will probably be the other cable, right? Shahid is asking what happened to Dwarf Fortress. Well, it turns out we were not quite sealed off from the fun. There's nothing to solve here yet. Now let's hang around over there. Oh. Okay, let's do this. This is point symmetry, probably. Haha, got it. It's the same pattern here and here. Will it be the same pattern over here? It will. Something happened. Ah, this wire is now lit. Okay, we know what to do here. We must go through all of these black dots. This doesn't seem to be activated quite yet. Yeah. Wait a moment, but that doesn't. Okay, we need to unlock it first, I think. Right? Or is there a way? Because I see no w incoming wire. I guess we must first unlock it, so go this way first. This must be activated first. Activated. Activated, activated over there. Ooh. Okay, this seems to be locked. It's all serially connected. From where? From here. Okay, so this is the first puzzle. You got me there. Interesting. Most interesting. Oh. So very interesting. Ah, got it. Okay. Okay. Okay, there we go. Oh, what are the green dots? I mean, the blue dots and the yellow dots. Ah, okay. The yellow line has to go through yellow dots, the blue line through blue dots. Wait. Ah, that was a blue one. Wow. Okay. Well, let's start. Ah, okay, get it. So wherever you start, starts the blue one. It's either here or here. Wherever you start, starts the blue one. OK. Okay. Yeah. Almost. But that's still possible. Well, not from here. Okay. Let's start from here. That's not possible. We must start from here, I think. Oh, this is difficult. But not too difficult. Think. The yellow line is ever so weaker. Seems like I need okay, I will need to solve more puzzles elsewhere. Okay. Oh yes, we made it. There's one more thing down here. Just how do we get there? Like this. First, we will have to solve a puzzle which is somewhere over here. I get it. Okay. Okay, let's solve this thing. What's wrong with this one? Does it have any additional wires to it? What's the point here? That I don't know. What could it want? What could this puzzle possibly want? Is not timed. I don't know. That remains to be seen. So now we have opened this, unlocked this, and we can solve it. Where to start? The symmetry. Okay, so what did this one do? We don't know. This one. We don't know what this one wants. No idea yet, no idea. Same as the one puzzled down there. Either it's not completely powered or I'm missing some sort of knowledge. We will revisit it later on. What is this? Black obelisk. And it's humming. Wow, lots of puzzles, but then over there are some. I'm running wildly across the island. Let's try to do it more systematically. I think I shouldn't have been here at this time when I don't understand those puzzles. We solved pretty much everything which was over here. Except for the binary things there. There was no puzzle, was it? It's just to show you some. This is a box. Can possibly be opened. Solved everything here. I don't know what to do now. Well, okay, let's stroll around and take a look at other puzzles. Plenty of them. So I was interested to see these pink trees. Maybe we are supposed to follow the brown way here. If we follow the brown way, we solved this as far as we can. Here is the brown way. Okay, and here we are again. Okay, so wasn't really worth it, was it? Pink trees. But before we go to pink trees, we can. Ah, we had a look at this already. Okay, so pink trees. Glowing with colors of all sorts of colors. So many ways to go. Let's start here. There's an apple on this tree. This is the same structure as the tree over there with the apple. There we go. like this. Where does the cable go? Cable goes here. Uh-huh. It's left, right, I mean, left, right, right, left. Left, right, right, left. Okay, this could be left, right, right, right. Let's try it. Left, right, right, right. This is left, right. Left, right, right, or left, left, right, left, right, right, left, left, right, yeah, so you have to follow the twigs. It's actually, I was wondering whether this is actually left or right, because it's skewed. It's actually left, right, right, yeah, and it, everything shut down now. And this, as we know, is left, right, right, left, right, right. Wait, 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 wait. Left, right. Right. Aha, wait, the key is not left, right, whether they are rotated, but the key is the missing branch. The missing branch at the tree is over here, so I have to look at it like this. I have to look at it from this perspective, where the missing branch is. So now I see the missing branch, and I can see clearly that the apple is one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine at the ninth branch from the left. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Over there. Mm-hmm. So where is the apple? Apple is nowhere. Oh, this is difficult. And then Maybe there's a pattern to where the apple is. And it can be deducted where the apple, in theory, should be here. So let's go back and see. So here, it all starts here. The apple is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, right? At the 12th position. Here the apple is at the 7th. Bleh. I see no pattern. Here the apple is at the No, not like this. How did I solve this one? I said it's left, right, right, right. I can't see a pattern. I can't see a pattern which would allow me to predict at which position the apple would be here. No matter how I'm thinking about these graphs, can't seem to find an answer. I have no idea. No idea here. Maybe some other place we will see a drawing of such a tree. And it will all make sense suddenly. Interesting, interesting. Okay. No idea what to do the what to do here. This is big. I wonder, I'm still thinking, what did I miss at the apple trees? Tree without an apple. Okay, here's a puzzle I can solve, I hope. It's like the windmill. So it's either or here, either this or that. It's a switch. Oh, that's one of the openings here, yeah. Oh. Of course, yes. No, still don't know. Then what am I missing here? Probably that one. Ah, I've seen this. We have seen this, haven't we? It was the paper in the safe. Must get back there. Where am I going? Was somewhere here. This is what we've seen. So we start here. Go like this. Start and go. Then we go left, left. Left, left. Right, 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 left, left. Left, left, right, 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 left, left. Oh, look at this.
Well, that's no better a solution than any of the others, is it?
No.
So, in the end, have we learned anything from this look at why the world turned out the way it did that's of any use to us in our future? Something, I think. That the key to why things change is the key to everything. How easy is it for knowledge to spread? And that in the past, the people who made change happen were the people who had that knowledge, whether they were craftsmen or kings. Today, the people who make things change, the people who have that knowledge, are the scientists and the technologists who are the true driving force of humanity. And before you say, what about the Beethovens and the Michelangelos? Let me suggest something with which you may disagree violently. That at best, the products of human emotion, art, philosophy, politics, music, literature, are interpretations of the world that tell you more about the guy who's talking than about the world he's talking about. Second-hand views of the world, made third-hand by your interpretation of them. Things like that. As opposed to this. Know what it is? It's a bunch of amino acids. The stuff that goes to build up a worm, or a geranium, or you. This stuff's easier to take, isn't it? Understandable. Got people in it. This, scientific knowledge, is hard to take because it removes the reassuring crutches of opinion, ideology, and leaves only what is demonstrably true about the world. And the reason why so many people may be thinking about throwing away those crutches is because, thanks to science and technology, they have begun to know that they don't know so much, and that if they are to have more say in what happens to their lives, more freedom to develop their abilities to the full, they have to be helped towards that knowledge that they know exists and that they don't possess. And by help towards that knowledge, I don't mean give everybody a computer and say, help yourself. Where would you even start? No, I mean trying to find ways to translate the knowledge, to teach us to ask the right questions. See, we're on the edge of a revolution in communications technology that is going to make that more possible than ever before. Or, if that's not done, to cause an explosion of knowledge that will leave those of us who don't have access to it as powerless as if we were deaf, dumb, and blind. And I don't think most people want that. So what do we do about it? I don't know. But maybe a good start would be to recognize within yourself the ability to understand anything, because that ability's there, as long as it's explained clearly enough. And then go and ask for explanations. And if you're thinking right now, what do I ask for? Ask yourself if there's anything in your life that you want changed. That's where to start.
Oh, did I interrupt it? Maybe there was some important information in the credits. Okay, I think this is a nice closing thought for this session. Think about what the guy said. I think I have to listen to it a couple more times before I grasp the meaning more innately. We try to continue next time. Thanks for watching.